According to all known laws of aviation, there is no way a bee should be able to fly. Its wings are too small to get its fat little body off the ground. The bee, of course, flies anyway because bees don't care what humans think is impossible. Yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black. Ooh, black and yellow, let's shake it up a little. Barry, breakfast is ready. Coming, hang on a second. Hello, Barry, Adam, can you believe this is happening? I can't, I'll pick you up. Looking sharp, use the stairs, your father paid good money for those. Sorry, I'm excited. Here's the graduate, we're very proud of you, son. A perfect report card, all B's, very proud. Ma, I got a thing going here. You got lint on your fuzz. Ow, that's me. Wave to us. We'll be in a row 118,000. Bye. Barry, I told you stop flying in the house. Hey, Adam. Hey, Barry. Is that fuzz gel? A little special day graduation. Never thought I'd make it. 3 days grade school, 3 days high school. Those were awkward. 3 days college. I'm glad I took a day and hitchhiked around the hive. You did come back different. Hi, Barry. Artie, growing a mustache, looks good. Hear about Frankie? Yeah. You going to the funeral? No, I'm not going. Everyone knows you sting someone, you die. Don't waste it on a squirrel, such a hothead. I guess he could have just gotten out of the way. I love this incorporating an amusement park into our day. That's why we don't need a vacation. Boy, quite a bit of pomp under the circumstances. Well, Adam, today we are men. We are B-men. Amen. Hallelujah. Students, faculty, distinguished bees, please welcome Dean Buswell. Welcome, New Hive City, graduating class of 915. That concludes our ceremonies and begins your career at Honex Industries. Will we pick our job today? I heard it's just orientation. Heads up, here we go. Keep your hands and antennas inside the tram at all times. Wonder what it'll be like. A little scary. Welcome to Honex, a division of Honsco, a part of the Hexagon Group. This is it. Wow. Wow. We know that you, as a bee, have worked your whole life to get to the point where you can work for your whole life. Honey begins when our valiant pollen jocks bring the nectar to the hive. Our top secret formula is automatically color corrected, scent adjusted, and bubble contoured into this soothing sweet syrup. With its distinctive golden glow, you know as honey. That girl was hot. She is my cousin. She is? Yes, we're all cousins. Right? You're right. At Honex, we constantly strive to improve every aspect of bee existence. These bees are stress testing a new helmet technology. What do you think he makes? Not enough. Here we have our latest advancement, the Krellman. What does that do? Catches the little strand of honey that hangs after you pour it. Saves us millions. Can anyone work on the Krellman? Of course! Most bee jobs are small ones, but bees know that every small job, if done well, means a lot. But choose carefully because you'll stay in the job you pick for the rest of your life. The same job the rest of your life? I didn't know that. What's the difference? You'll be happy to know that bees as a species haven't had one day off in 27 million years. So you'll just work us to death? Well, sure try. Well, that blew my mind. What's the difference? How can you say that? One job forever? That's an insane choice to have to make. I'm relieved. Now we only have to make one decision in life. But Adam, how could they never have told us that? Why would you question anything? We're bees. We're the most perfectly functioning society on Earth. You ever think maybe things work a little too... little too well here? Like what? Give me an example. I don't know, but you know what I'm talking about. Please clear the gate. Royal Nectar Force on approach. Wait a second, check it out. Hey, those are pollen jocks. Wow, I've never seen them this close. They know what it's like outside the hive. Yeah, but some don't come back. Hi, jocks. Hey, jocks. You guys did great. You're monsters. You're sky freaks. I love it. I love it. I wonder where they were. I don't know. Their day's not planned. Outside the hive, flying who knows where, doing who knows what. You can't just decide to be a pollen jock. You have to be bred for that. Right! Look, that's more pollen than you'll see in a lifetime! It's just the status symbol! Bees make too much of it! Perhaps unless you're wearing it and the ladies see you wearing it. Those ladies, aren't they our cousins too? Distant, distant. Look at these two couple of hive harries. Let's have fun with them. Ugh. It must be dangerous being a pollen jock. Yeah, once a bear pinned me against a mushroom. He had a pollen in my throat and with the other he was slapping me. Oh my, I never thought I'd knock him out. Where were you during this, trying to alert the authorities? I can autograph that. A little gusty out there today, wasn't it, comrades? Yeah, gusty, we're hitting a sunflower patch 6 miles over here tomorrow. 6 miles, huh? Barry, a puddle jump for us, but maybe you're not out there. Maybe I am, you are not. We're going 0900 at J Gate. What do you think, Buzzy Boy? Are you B enough? Well, I might be. It all depends on what 0900 means. Hey, Onyx, Daddy, surprise me. You decide what you're interested in? Well, there's a lot of choices, but you only get one. Do you ever get bored doing the same job every day? Sunlight. Let me tell you something. You grab that stick and you move it around and you stir it around. You get yourself into a beautiful rhythm. It's a beautiful thing. I know, Dad. The more I know about it, maybe the honey field isn't right for me. What, you were thinking of what? Making balloon animals? That's a bad job for a guy with a stinger. Janet, your son's not sure he wants to go into honey. Barry, you are so funny sometimes. I'm not trying to be funny. You're not funny. Are going into honey, our son, the stirrer. You're going to be a stirrer? No one's listening to me. Wait till you see the sticks I have. I could say anything right now. I'm going to get an ant tattoo. Let's open some honey and celebrate. Maybe I'll pierce my thorax, shave my antennae, shack up with a grasshopper, get a cold tooth, and call everyone dog. I'm so proud. We're starting the work today. Today's the day. Come on, all the good jobs will be gone. Yeah, right. Pollen counting, stunt bee, pouring stir, front desk hair removal. Is it still available? Hang on, two left. One of them's yours. Congratulations. Step to the side. What do you get? Picking crud out? Stellar. Wow, couple of newbies. Yes, sir. Our first day. We are ready. Make your first choice. Can't do this. You want to go first? No, you go. Oh my, what's available? Restroom attendance open. Not for the reason you think. Any chance of getting the Krellman? Sure you're on. I'm sorry, the Krellman just closed out. Wax Monkey's always open. The Krellman closed up again. What happened? The bee died. Makes an opening. C is dead. Another dead one. Deady. Deadified. Two more dead. Oh, this is so hard. Heating, cooling, stunting. Heating, cooling, stump bee, pour, stirrer, humming, inspector number 7, link coordinator, stripe, supervisor, might, wrangler. Barry, what do you think I should? Barry? Barry! All right, we've got sunflower patch in quadrant 9. What happened to you? Where were you? I'm going out. Out? Out where? Out there. Oh no! I have to before I go to work for the rest of my life. You're gonna die! You're crazy! Hello? Another call coming in. If anyone's feeling brave, there's a Korean deli on 83rd that gets their roses today. Hey guys, look at that. Isn't the kid we saw yesterday? Hold it, son. Flight deck's restricted. It's okay, Lo. We're going to take him up. Really? Feeling lucky, are you? Sign here. Here. Just initial that. Thank you. Okay. You got a rain advisory today. And as you all know, bees cannot fly in rain. So be careful as always. Watch your brooms, hockey sticks, dogs, birds, bears, and bats. Also, I get a couple of reports of root beer being poured on us. Murphy's in a home because of it. Babbling cicada. That's awful. And a reminder for you rookies, bee law number 1, absolutely no talking to humans. Alright, launch positions! Buzz, 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 buzz. Black and yellow, hello, you ready for this hot shot? Yeah, bring it on. Wind check, antenna check, nectar pack check, wings check, stinger check. Scared out of my shorts check. Okay, ladies, let's move it out. Pound those petunias, you striped stem stuckers. All of you, drain those flowers. Wow, I'm out. I can't believe I'm out. So blue. I feel so fast and free. Boxkite, wow, flowers. This is blue leader. We have roses on visual. Bring it around 30 degrees and hold. Roses, 30 degrees, Roger, bringing it around. Stand to the side, kid. It's got a bit of a kick. That is in one nectar collector. Ever see pollination up close? No, sir! I pick up some pollen over here, sprinkle it over here, maybe a dash over there. A pinch on that one. See that? It's a little bit of magic. That's amazing. Why do we do that? That's pollen flower. More pollen, more flowers, more nectar, more honey for us. Cool. I'm picking up a lot of bright yellow. Could be daisies. Don't we need those? Copy that, visual. Wait, one of these flowers seems to be on the move. Say again, you're reporting a moving flower? Affirmative. That was on the line. This is the coolest. What is it? I don't know, but I'm loving this color. It smells good. Not like a flower, but I like it. Yeah, fuzzy. Chemically. Careful, guys. It's a little grabby. Sweet Lord of Bees. Candy brain, get off there. Problem. Guys, this could be bad. Affirmative. Very close. Gonna hurt mama's little boy. You're out. Way of position, rookie. Coming in at you like a missile. Help me. I don't think those are flowers. Should we tell him? I think he knows. What is this? Match point. You can start packing up, honey, because you're about to eat it. Yowzer, gross. There's a bee in the car. I'll do something. I'm driving. Hi, bee. Back here. He's going to sting me. Nobody move. If you don't move, he won't sting you. Freeze. He blinked. Spray him, Granny. What are you doing? The tension level out here is unbelievable. Gotta get home. Can't fly in the rain. Can't fly in the rain. Can't fly in the rain. Mayday. Mayday. Bee going down. Ken, could you close the window, please? Ken, could you close the window, please? Check out my new resume. I made it into a fold-out brochure. You see, folds out. No, no, more humans. I don't need this. What was that? Maybe this time, this time, this time, this time, this time. This. Drapes. That's diabolical. It's fantastic. I've got all my special skills, even my top 10 favorite movies. What's number one? Star Wars. Nah, I don't go for that kind of stuff. No wonder we shouldn't talk to them. They're out of their minds. When I leave a job interview, they're flabbergasted. Can't believe what I say. There's the sun. Maybe that's a way out. I don't remember the sun having a big 75 on it. I predicted global warming. I could feel it getting hotter. At first, I thought it was just me. Wait! Stop! B! Stand back. Those are winter boots. Wait, don't kill him. You know I'm allergic to them. This thing could kill me. Why does his life have less value than yours? Why does his life have any less value than mine? Is that your statement? I'm saying all life has value. You don't know that what he's saying has capable of feeling. My brochure! There you go, little guy. I'm not scared of him. It's an allergic thing. Put that on your resume, brochure. My whole face could puff up. Make it one of your special skills. Knocking someone out is also a special skill. Right, bye, Vanessa. Thanks. Vanessa, next week, yogurt night? Sure, Ken, you know, whatever. You could put carob chips on there. Bye. Supposed to be on less calories. I gotta say something. She saved my life. I gotta say something. All right, here it goes. Now, what should I say? I could really get in trouble. It's a bee law. You're not supposed to talk to a human. I can't believe I'm doing this. I've got to. Oh, I can't do it. Come on. No, yes, no. Do it. I can't. How should I start it? You like jazz? No, that's no good. Here she comes. Speak, you fool. Hi, I'm sorry. You're talking. Yes, I know. You're talking. I'm so sorry. No, it's okay. It's fine. I know I'm dreaming, but I don't recall going to bed. Well, I'm sure this is very disconcerting. Certing. This is a bit of a surprise to me. I mean, you're a bee! I am not supposed to be doing this, but they were all trying to kill me. And if it wasn't for you, I had to thank you. It's just how I was raised. That was a little weird. I'm talking with a bee. Yeah, I'm talking to a bee, and a bee is talking to me. I just want to say I'm grateful. I'll leave now. What? How did you learn to do that? What? The talking thing. Same way you did, I guess. Mama, daddy, honey, you pick it up. That's very funny. Yeah, bees are funny. If we didn't laugh, we'd cry with what we had to deal with. Anyway, can I get you something? Like what? I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Coffee? I don't want to put you out. It's no trouble. It takes 2 minutes. I hate coffee. I hate to impose. Don't be ridiculous, actually. Actually, I would love a cup. Hey, you want rum cake? I shouldn't. Have some. No, I can't. Come on. I'm trying to lose a couple micrograms. Where? These stripes don't help. You look great. I don't know anything if you know anything about fashion. Are you all right? No. He's making the tie in the cab as they're flying up Madison. He finally gets there. He runs up the steps into the church. The wedding is on. And he says, watermelon? I thought you said Rodzemelon. Why would I marry a watermelon? Is that a bee joke? That's the kind of stuff we do. Yeah, oh, wait. Why would I marry a watermelon? Is that a bee joke? Yeah, that's the kind of stuff we do. Yeah, different. So what are you gonna do, Barry? About work? I don't know. Shite, I messed up. And he says, watermelon! And I thought you said, Guatemalan! Why wouldn't I marry a watermelon? Is that a bee joke? Yeah, that's the kind of stuff we do. Yeah, different. So what are you gonna do, Barry? About work? I don't know. I want to do my part for the hive, but I can't do it the way they want. I know how you feel. You do? Sure. My parents wanted me to be a lawyer or a doctor, but I wanted to be a florist. Really? My only interest is flowers! Our new queen was just elected with that same campaign slogan. Anyway, if you look, there's my hive right there. See it? You're in Sheep Meadow. Yes, I'm right off the turtle pond. No way, I know that area. I lost a toe ring there once. Why do girls put rings on their toes? Why not? It's like putting a hat on your knee. Maybe I'll try that. You all right, ma'am? Oh yeah, fine. Just having 2 cups of coffee. Anyway, this has been great. Thanks for the coffee. Yeah, it's no trouble. Sorry I couldn't finish it. If I did, I'd be up the rest of my life. Can I take a piece of this with me? Sure. Here, have a crumb! Thanks. Yeah. Alright, well then I guess I'll see you around. Or not. Okay, Barry. And thank you so much again for before. Oh, that was nothing. Well, not nothing, but anyway, this can't possibly work. He's all set to go. We may as well try it. Okay, Dave, pull the chute. Sounds amazing. It was amazing. It was the scariest, happiest moment of my life. Humans, I can't believe you were with humans. Giant, scary humans. What were they like? Huge and crazy. They talk crazy. They eat crazy giant things. They drive crazy. Do they try and kill you like on TV? Some of them, but some of them don't. How'd you get back? Poodle. You did, and one, I'm glad. You saw whatever you wanted to see. You had your experience. Now you can pick out your job and be normal. Well, I met someone. You did? Was she bee-ish? A wasp? Your parents will kill you. No, not a wasp. Spider? I'm not attracted to spiders. I know it's the hottest thing with the 8 legs and all. But I can't get by that face. So who is she? She's human. No, that's a bee law. You wouldn't break a bee law. Her name's Vanessa. Oh boy, she's so nice and she's a florist. Oh no, you're dating a human florist. We're not dating. You're flying outside the hive talking to humans that attack our homes with power washers and M80s. One ate the stick of dynamite. She saved my life. And she understands me. This is over. Eat this. This is not over. What was that? They call it a crumb. It was so stinging stripey. And that's not what they eat. That's what falls off what they eat. You know what a Cinnabon is? No, it's bread and cinnamon with frosting. They heat it up. Sit down. Sit down. Really hot. Listen to me. We are not them. We're us. There's us and there's them. Yes, but who can deny the heart that is yearning? There's no yearning. Stop yearning. Listen to me. You've got to start thinking B, my friend. Thinking B. There he is. He's in the pool. You know what your problem is, Barry? I gotta start thinking B. How much longer will this go on? It's been 3 days. Why aren't you working? I've got a lot of big life decisions to think about. What life? You have no life. You have no job. You're barely a bee. Would it kill you to make a little honey? Barry, come out. Your father's talking to you. Martin, would you talk to him? Barry, I'm talking to you. You coming? Got everything. Oh. Go ahead. I'll catch up. Don't be too long. Watch this, Vanessa. We're still here. I told you not to yell at him. He doesn't respond to yelling. Then why yell at me? Because you don't listen. I'm not listening to this. Sorry, I've got to go. Where are you going? I'm meeting a friend. A girl? Is this why you can't decide? Bye. I just hope she's B-ish. They have a huge parade of flowers every year in Pasadena. To be in the Tournament of Roses, that's like every florist's dream. Up on a float, surrounded by flowers, crowds cheering. A tournament, do the roses compete in athletic events? No! All right, I've got one. How come you don't fly everywhere? It's exhausting. Why don't you run everywhere? It's faster. Yeah, okay. Okay, I see. I see. All right, your turn. TiVo, you can just freeze live TV? That's insane. You don't have that? We have HeVo, but it's a horrible disease. It's a horrible, horrible disease. Oh my, dumb bees! You must want to sting all those jerks. We try not to sting. It's usually fatal for us. So you have to watch your temper very carefully. You kick a wall, take a walk, write an angry letter and throw it out. Work through it like any emotion. Anger, jealousy, lust! Oh my goodness, are you okay? Yeah. What's wrong with you? It's a bug. He's not bothering anyone. Get out of here, you creep. What was that? A pick and save circular? Yeah, it was. How did you know? It felt like 10 pages. 75 is pretty much our limit. You've got to really, really got that down to a science. I lost a cousin to Italian vote. I'll bet. What in the name of mighty Hercules is this? How did this get here? Altepi, golden blossom. Ray Liotta, private select. Is he that actor? I've never heard of him. Why is this here? For people. We eat it. You don't have enough food of your own? Well, yes. How do you get it? Bees make it. I know who makes it, and it's hard to make it. There's heating, cooling, stirring, and a whole Krellman thing. It's organic. It's our organic. It's just honey, Barry. Just what? Bees don't know a lot this. This is stealing. A lot of stealing. You've taken our homes, schools, hospitals. This is all we have. And it's on sale? I'm getting to the bottom of this. I'm getting to the bottom of all of this. Hey, Hector, you done? You almost done? Almost. Here he is. I sense it. Well, I guess I'll go home now and just leave this nice honey out with no one around. You're busted, box boy. I knew I heard something. So you can talk. I can talk. And now you'll start talking. Where are you getting the speed stuff? Who's your supplier? I don't understand. I thought we were friends. The last thing we want to do is upset bees. You're too late. It's ours now. You, sir, have crossed the wrong sword. You, sir, will be lunch for my iguana. Ignacio, where's the honey coming from? Tell me where. Honey farms. It comes from honey farms. Crazy person. What horrible thing has happened here? These faces, they never knew what hit them. And now, they're on the road to nowhere. Just keep still. What, you're not dead? Do I look dead? They will wipe anything that moves. Where are you headed to honey farms? I am onto something huge here. Where are, I'm going to Alaska. Moose blood, crazy stuff. Blows your head off. And you, he really is dead. All right, uh-oh, what is that? Oh no, a wiper, triple play, jump on, it's your only chance, B. Why does everything have to be so doggone clean? How much do you people need to see? Open your eyes, stick your head out the window from NPR News in Washington. I'm Carl Kassel, but don't kill no more bugs. B, moose blood guy. You hear something? Like what? Like tiny screaming. Turn off the radio. What's up, B-boy? Hey, bud. Just a row of honey jars as far as the eye could see. Wow! I assume wherever this truck goes is where they're getting it. I mean, that honey's ours. Bees, hang tight. We're all jammed in. It's a close community. Not us, man. We on our own. Every mosquito on his own. What if you get in trouble? You mosquito, you in trouble. Nobody likes us. They just smack. They see a mosquito. Smack, smack. At least you're out in the world. You must meet girls. Mosquito girls try trade up, get with a moth, the dragonfly. Mosquito girl don't want no mosquito. You gotta be kidding me. Moose Blood's about to leave the building. So long, B. Hey, guys. Moose Blood. I knew I'd catch y'all down here. Did you bring your crazy straw? We throw it in jars, slap a label on it, and it's pretty much pure profit. What is this place? A bee's got a brain size of a pinhead. They are pinheads. Pinhead. Check out the new smoker. Oh, sweet, that's the one you want. The Thomas 3000 smoker. 90 puffs a minute, semi-automatic, twice the nicotine, all the tar. A couple bricks of this knocks them right out. They make the honey and we make the money. They make the honey and we make the money. Oh my, what's going on? Are you okay? Yeah, it doesn't last too long. Do you know you're in a fake hive with fake walls? Our queen has moved here. We had no choice. This is your queen? This is a man in woman's clothes. That's a drag queen. What is this? Oh no, there's hundreds of them. Bee honey. Our honey is being presently stolen on a massive scale. This is worse than anything bears have done. I intend to do something. Oh, Barry, stop. Who told you humans are taking our honey? That's a rumor. Do these look like rumors? There's a conspiracy theory. They're obviously doctored photos. How did you get mixed up in this? He's been talking to humans. What? Talking to humans? He has a human girlfriend. And they make out. Make out? Barry, we do not. You wish you could. Whose side are you on? The bees! I dated a cricket once in San Antonio. Those crazy legs kept me up all night. Barry, this is what you want to do with your life? I want to do it for all our lives. Nobody works harder than bees. Dad, I remember you coming home so overworked. Your hands were still starring. You couldn't stop. I remember that. What right do they have to our honey? We live on 2 cups a year. They put it in lip balm for no reason whatsoever. Even if it's true, what can one bee do? Sting them where it really hurts. In the face. In the eye. That would hurt. No. Up the nose? That's a killer. There's only one place where you can sting the humans. One place where it matters. Hive at 5, the Hive's only full-hour action news stores. No more bee beards with Bomb Bumble at the anchor desk. Weather with Storm Stinger Sports and Buzz Buzz Larvae. And Jeanette Chung. Good evening, I'm Bob Bungle. And I'm Jeanette Chung. A tri-country bee, Barry Benson, intends to sue the human race for stealing our money, packaging it, and profiting from it illegally. Tomorrow night on Bee Larry King, we'll have 3 former queens here in our studio discussing their book, Classy Ladies, out this week on Hexagon. Tonight we're talking to Barry B. Benson. Did you ever think, I'm a kid from the Hive, I can't do this? Bees have never been afraid to change the world. What about Bee Columbus, Bee Gandhi, Bee Jesus? Where I'm from, we'd never sue humans. We were thinking of stickball or candy stores. How old are you? The bee community is supporting you in this case, which would be the trial of the bee century. You know, they have a Larry King in the human world, too. It's a common name. Next week, he looks like you and has a show in suspenders and colored dots. Next week, glasses, quotes on the bottom from the guest, even though you just heard him. Bear week next week. They're scary, hairy, and here live. Always leans forward, pointy shoulders, squinty eyes. Very Jewish. In tennis, you attack at the point of weakness. It was my grandmother, Ken. She's 81. backhand's harder than it looks. Honey, her backhand's a joke. I'm not gonna take advantage of that. Quiet, please. Actual work going on here. Is that the same bee? Yes, it is. I'm helping him sue the human race. Hello, bee. This is Ken. Yeah, I remember you. Timberland size 10 and a half Vibram sole, I believe. Why does he talk again? Listen, you better go, because we're a bit really busy working. But it's our yogurt night. Bye-bye. Why is yogurt night so difficult? Yes, and Adam here has been a huge help. Frosting, how many sugars? Just one, I try not to use the competition. So why are you helping me? Bees have good qualities, and it takes my mind off the shop. Instead of those flowers, people are giving balloon bouquets now. Those are great if you're three, and artificial flowers. Oh, those just get me psychotic. Yeah, me too. Bent stingers, pointless pollination. Bees must hate those fake things. Nothing worse than a daffodil that's had work done. Maybe this could make up for it a little bit. This lawsuit's a pretty big deal, I guess. You sure you want to go through with it? Am I sure? When I'm done with the humans, they won't be able to say, honey, I'm home, without paying a royalty. It's an incredible scene here in downtown Manhattan, where the world anxiously waits because for the first time in history, we are healed for ourselves if a honeybee can actually speak. What have we gotten into here, Barry? It's pretty big, isn't it? I can't believe how many humans don't work during the day. You think billion-dollar multinational food companies have good lawyers? Everybody needs to stay behind the barricade. What's the matter? I don't know, I just gotta chill. Well, 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 if it isn't the B team, you boys work on this? All rise. The Honorable Judge Bumbleton presiding. All right, case number 4475. Superior Court of New York, Barry B. Benson v. The honey industry is now in session. Mr. Montgomery, you're representing the five food companies collectively. A privilege. Mr. Benson, you're representing all bees of the world. I'm kidding. Yes, Your Honor, we're ready to proceed. Mr. Montgomery, your opening statement, please. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my grandmother was a simple woman, born on